What's going on, YouTube? Ryan Vidguy here. Today I want to talk to you about insurance costs on iPhone carriers around the United States anyway, and why you really shouldn't be using them as insurance when you should be using Apple. So let's take a quick look at the rates of the insurance pricing on the top four major carriers in the United States: AT&T, Verizon, T-Mobile, and Sprint, all very popular in the United States. Their insurance prices are as follows, and I'll pull it up here so you can see it as well. AT&T, you're looking at $7 a month with a $199 deductible to replace the iPhone. So all that's doing is taking off, or it is bringing back the subsidized price. So it's probably the same price you paid when you purchased the device, if not off by $100 or so, depending on if you got the increased capacity. So you're paying a monthly price, plus you're paying a large deductible. On Verizon, you're paying $10 a month, and you have a couple different prices. If you have the 8GB or the 16GB, which are the most popular models, the 16GB is the most popular anyway, you're looking at $169 for the deductible, and $199 for 32GB and 64GB. Keep in mind that these replacement units on all these carriers are listed as either new or refurbished, and they're not going to tell you which one's which. So you're kind of looking at an iffy spectrum there as far as that. On Sprint, you're looking at $11 a month insurance cost with $199 deductible to replace the iPhone. Again, new or refurbished. On T-Mobile, took me a little bit of more time to find this plan. Looking at $8 a month insurance cost and $175 to replace the newer iPhones anyway. So I saw it's listed that as the iPhone 5. Probably iPhone 5S is involved in that as well. I'm not too sure about the iPhone 4S. But the point is, guys, you're looking at a monthly rate for insurance when you shouldn't even have to pay a monthly rate for insurance. The thing is, if you buy your iPhone through one of these carriers, they most of the time avoid telling you about Apple's insurance options, which they have. So let's go ahead and take a look at those. Tried to clean this up a little bit for you by putting some red paint using Photoshop exactly where I want you to look. But Apple Care Plus is Apple's insurance, basically. You pay $99. That's a one-time fee. In my opinion, beats paying the monthly bill for the insurance. And basically, it gives you two accidental damages. So let's say you dropped it in the toilet. Let's say you went swimming with it on accident. Let's say you cracked your screen, which is a popular, or not popular, but most common problem with the iPhones. It's covered under basically a deductible of $79, which is a lot cheaper. And if you're less likely to break your device because maybe you have a case on it, it's a good deal. I actually just got Apple Care Plus on this right here. Plus, it gives you the benefit of extending your 1 year warranty with your device that you already get. Obviously, that 1 year warranty doesn't cover accidental damage or anything like that, but it does cover manufacturer defects. That is extended up to 2 years after that. So that's kind of a little plus as well. And I think it's gonna end up being cheaper in the long run as well. Now, the one benefit to insurance rates through carriers is it does cover a lot of times stolen iPhones or lost iPhones. I don't really have that problem. I don't really see people having that problem as much as them damaging the devices themselves. And then Apple offers a out-of-warranty service. So this is if you pay no insurance. This is if you pay, you know, nothing at all. You just bought the iPhone and something happened. There is something called an out-of-warranty service at Apple that Apple doesn't tell people a lot about. It's actually not even really that widely known. But let's say I were to crack this iPhone 5S tomorrow and I didn't have any kind of Apple Care on it. You know, I just had the one-year warranty that it came with, which, again, doesn't cover accidental damage. I would be able to pay $269.99 to get that replaced out of warranty. Yeah, it's a little bit more than the deductibles on the carriers, but I'm not paying a monthly service fee either. So you gotta look at it like that. You know the carriers are making quite a bit of profit off of this insurance. So the $269 out of warranty replacement, you're looking at the iPhone 5S, iPhone 5C, and iPhone 5 for that. For the iPhone 4S, you're looking at $199 out of warranty replacement. And then for the iPhone 4, iPhone 3GS, iPhone 3G, and original iPhone, you're looking at $149. So those are the rates for Apple, and in my opinion, Apple is the way to go. Obviously, you'll evaluate your spending and figure out exactly what you want to do based on your, you know, your uses of the insurance. But I really don't think that insurance through carriers is the best way to go. In fact, I kind of consider it a scam, in my opinion. But that's all I have to say about that, guys. I just wanted to get that out there for you to kind of take into account, either before you purchase an iPhone or, you know, if you're within 30 days of purchasing the phone, you can always go out and purchase AppleCare. You can cancel your insurance with your carrier. If you have the insurance right now, you might even consider canceling the insurance just for Apple's out-of-warranty service. So if you have any questions about that, guys, leave a comment below. I'll try to answer it if I can. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if this helped you out. I'll see you in the next video.